guys, it's me, Grace, and you may notice I'm not in my usual setting. I'm in my brother's room because he doesn't live at home, so I turned his desk area into my art studio, art area, whatever you want to call it. So I bullet journal here, I paint here, and my friend Ken was like, you should do a bullet journal with me. So that's what we're going to be doing today. I have my bullet journal here. I haven't bullet journaled in a solid month, so I think that, you know, what better time than now to catch up and do my August spread with you guys, because I do like a new theme each month. I'll be going into like things that I use for bullet journaling basic setup for, you know, that I like, and also I'll probably have a time lapse, that way you can see from like the top what I'm doing. Hope you enjoy this video. I am really excited to get started. So sorry if the camera angle is a little different. I just got back from dinner, so obviously I had to readjust. But while I'm doing a time lapse or something, I'm gonna put this section in the corner so that you guys are gonna know what supplies I use and everything, while also you can get a look of my spread while I'm working on it. Also, another thing that I wanted to cover while I'm doing the time lapse is when I do my spreads, I usually do a monthly cover, so that's where I kind of establish the theme that I'm going to do for that month, and then after that I'm going to be doing like a monthly overview that kind of is like a calendar of the entire month, where I can fill in what days I'm busy, what days I'm have activities or whatever. I like to do a playlist spread for each month where I print out little pictures of the album covers, but I know that it's a little bit more high maintenance, so you obviously wouldn't have to do that. And then I like to do a highlights page. Sometimes I do habit trackers, mood trackers, not all the time though. And then lastly, what I do for like weekly or daily is I will just have like a page dedicated to 2 days, so I'll split it in half, or a page dedicated to 3 days, split that into thirds, and then just highlight a strip, write the date on it, and that way it's a little bit more simplistic. I know some days I go all out, some days I go more simplistic, so it's really up to you on how you wanna customize your journal, but that's just personally what I like to do for my spreads. So I would like to point out that my theme for August is gonna be sunflowers, and my nails match that, so I'm very excited about that. Okay, anyway, stationery. To start off with my journal itself, I use this Muji notebook. It's the Muji, I don't know what it's called actually. I don't know. It says A7 on the back. I couldn't find this on their site, but I had like a good alternative that I found that I will link in the description box. So if you want one of these, you can get yourself. Like, it has this clear covering on the front, so you can personalize this. I was too scared to, because like it's the very first page, it's, you know, see-through, so I didn't, but I think that's really nice. You can personalize it and it'll be like covered up and protected. And I also like the spiral because that makes it super easy. It's like a random page, but it makes it super easy to just flip back so that when you're working, it's a lot easier. So yeah, or I know a lot of people like moleskin journals, so I will link a couple of those options down below if you're looking to get a new journal. I highly recommend this one, but the Amazon one is probably gonna be just as great. Next, on to the pens and like, you know, overall stationery that I use within my journal. So I'm gonna only show you the essentials because I have my pencil case here, I have a lot of stuff in it, and I can't get through everything, but I'll show you what I use the most. Okay, so first thing is first, I think that everyone could use a good set of highlighters. These are the mild liners. I have quite a few of them. I like to arrange them in a rainbow pattern, you know. But personally, I think that with only one set, like they come in packs of three, with a pack of three you could still make beautiful spreads. So you obviously don't need to have all these colors, but I think that with each theme that you do each month or something, it's good to switch it up, but it's totally up to you. So I highly recommend these mild liners because, as you can see, this is like a red one. There is a chisel tip, so it's a bit wider for if you have, you know, bigger text, or if you want to underline or have smaller text, there is like a smaller tip. That's what she said. That was uncalled for. Anyway, so yeah, I highly recommend these mild liners. They're great. Following that, one pen that I use pretty much in every single one of my spreads is this Muji pen. You can get a pack of these on Amazon, and they're not like super expensive like the Pilot G2 pens, but they still write really well. I personally like the 0.38, but I also do have the 0.5 in case you like a thicker, you know, writing or whatever. But The Muji pens are going to save your life. They're so good for just notes in general, like homework or whatever, for school. Another thing that I use a lot when it comes to like art or if you need a finer line are these like uni pin liners. I will link everything down in the description. I don't know if I said that before, but I'll link everything that I have down in the description. That way, if you guys are interested in buying something, you can just get some for yourself, you know? So if you're ever like, I want to get that, then look in the description box. But basically, these come in different sizes, like the 0.1. This one is a different pen. I don't know why I'm freaking showing that. But so yeah, they come in different sizes and everything. So if you're an artist who needs a liner for their art, I recommend those. They're pretty cheap on Amazon. They're a lot cheaper than microns. And I know microns die out so easily. So those uni pen liners are going to be great. But yeah, I recommend these two for like writing or, you know, anything like that and art related too for these. So they are great pens. Following that, we have these, which are called the Papermate flare pens. And I know a lot of my classmates use these, but they're just like these pens. People use this for annotating, for notes, for anything. And you can use them for bullet journaling to, you know, have some accents here and there. If you want some color in your spread, I would recommend these too, because if you want colored pens, these can be a bit expensive, but I think that overall they're really nice to use and they come in a bunch of different colors. So these are also great. The next supply stationery that I love to use are the Tombow Fudenosuki. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but these are great hand lettering pens. They come in a pack on Amazon, or if you don't want to support Jeff Bezos, because you know, you can always get some at Michael's. I know they have them there. And same thing with any of the other products. If you don't want to support Amazon because Jeff Bezos, they are, go to Michael's. Michael's has all the crafts. You can get a bullet journal there, you can get pens there. Go to Michael's too. So you know what, I'll link a Michael's link as well. So I'll have the Amazon and Michael's link. You guys can choose whatever you want, but these are perfect for hand lettering. They come with a like a harder tip. I need to stop. They come with like a harder one, and then they come with a softer one for if you want a more like flowing you know, lettering. So I recommend these literally are so good. I remember I used to use markers, like, you know, those Crayola chisel tip markers, to line my pens or to do hand lettering, and it was really inefficient. So for these, it's perfect if you want a crisp black hand lettering. I would recommend the Tombow Fudenosuki pens. This is random, but I think two other things that aren't really pens that everyone should have in general, but also especially for bullet journaling, is a big eraser. These are the label is off, but this is like the high polymer eraser that pretty sure everyone has just for school. So you could totally use that, because I feel like if you mess up when you're sketching on your spread, you could just easily erase that if you do it carefully, versus like using the back of your pencil. That's kind of annoying. And then with that being said, a pencil, anyone needs a pencil to bullet journal for homework, for whatever, you're gonna have one already. So pencils are also really good for bullet journaling. And then with that eraser comes a whiteout, because I know sometimes when I'm going through my weekly spread or my monthly spread, I make a mistake with the pen because I want it to look aesthetically pleasing. But this will come in handy so you can easily correct it without having to like scribble something out. So you can literally get these at like Target or whatever. You can get them anywhere, so, you know, supply store or whatever. But yeah, I would highly recommend getting a whiteout like this or something from, this one's from Bic, but whatever brand you like. Just get a whiteout because they work. And the liquid ones I would stay away from, because those can get really messy. And I feel like as long as you take your time and you don't like purposely try to screw up, as long as you just a little pressure, go across. These are great because, I don't know, some people find a way to mess these up, but I think that the tape whiteouts are a lot better. So I would recommend getting one of these. So one of the last items that I want to show is something that you can use for coloring, and that is the Crayola Super Tips. I have a pencil case full of them, but basically they come in these huge packs, or you can get small packs too. It's up to you. You can get them at Michael's, Amazon, you know. They're probably gonna be with all the other coloring stuff, but they come in so many colors, and I feel like the tip is the perfect size for if you want to do any hand lettering, it's good for that. Or if you want to color something in, it's also good for that. I've used these for pretty much all my spreads and they are amazing. They come in so many colors. And with that being said, another thing that I love to use to color that I recently just acquired were these Tombow dual brush pens. Thank you to Lucy, I got these from her, but when she opened it up, it's that brush tip for beautiful hand lettering and coloring. And then at the end, you have a nice little chisel. I know that's not chisel, but like a, not like a felt tip, but you know, it's that's just for if you want to have any lines or anything. And I got the pastel set from Lucy. I just freaking dropped that. But yeah, these are gonna be so great. Thank you to her. And then again, this is one thing that's kind of unrelated, but I think that every bullet journaler should have. And that is a ruler, because I know I get lazy sometimes and I don't feel like doing straight lines in my spreads, but these do make a difference. And as much as we all get lazy, I think that having these in your bullet journal or for your bullet journal makes everything look a lot nicer and put together, because although the dots are there to guide you to do the straight lines, a ruler will always help you. So use a ruler. With that being said, one last tip that I will give you guys for bullet journaling is to go on and go on like Instagram, or you know, go for the hashtag bullet journal, or you know, hashtag BUJO, because you know, bullet journal. Bujo, hashtag Bujo, or you know, go to Pinterest and look up bullet journal inspiration, because there's so many cool pictures from there that you can get your inspiration from, because I know that sometimes that aspect of creativity is hard to come across. So I always use Pinterest because I think there's so many great ideas on there. But if you have not already, also I'm going to self-plug here, follow my art account at gracelou.art on Instagram. I have not been posting recently because I've been really busy with my internship, but after that, I'm going to be posting a lot more again. I usually post my spreads on there from my bullet journal, so hopefully after this video is done and I get a solid spread, I'll post something on there too. I thought this would be fun because I love bullet journaling and I wanted to share some of the things I love to use. So yeah, if you guys want more of these videos, let me know, because it's different from my vlogs. It's different from my fun, you know, high energy videos. I don't know if you would call them high energy, but they're more fun with the editing and everything. This one's more chill, but I really enjoyed making this and I hope that you guys enjoyed it too. So thank you so much for watching, and click subscribe, like this video, comment down below your favorite way to find ideas for your bullet journal or your favorite bullet journal theme that you've done. I want to hear those ideas because I'm lacking on the creativity side, so let me know. But yeah, I hope you guys like this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye. Love you guys.